Now, Senegal's new leader is being inaugurated as the country's president today after a surprise win largely driven by young voters hungry for change. Opposition leader Bassirou Diomaye Faye, or Diomaye Faye rather, promised to tackle corruption and protect Senegal's economy from the influence of foreign powers. He now faces a series of major challenges as he prepares to take office.
His supporters call him Mr. Clean. That's because President-elect Bassirou Diomaye Faye is promising a new Senegal.
The Senegalese people have chosen to break with the past. I pledge to govern with humility and transparency and to fight corruption at all levels. I pledge to devote myself fully to rebuilding our institutions and strengthening the foundations of our way of life together.
Faye is not a well-known political figure and only entered the leadership race as a substitute for his mentor Ousmane Sonko, a long-standing opposition force in the country who was disqualified from the election. Released from jail himself less than 2 weeks before the vote, 44-year-old Faye is now set to become Senegal's youngest president, riding on the back of Sonko's young supporters. You will see a different face of the Senegalese people and of Senegal because it's a total revolution. Everything is going to change behaviorally, socially, and financially. Everything is going to change. Faye appealed to jobless voters struggling under the weight of high unemployment. He also rallied support under a populist Pan-African platform that included promises of economic independence and a new currency not pegged to the euro. But Senegal will also start producing oil and gas this year, which could mean new international partnerships.
Senegal will always hold its ground and remain a friendly country and a reliable ally to any partner who engages with us in virtuous, respectful, and mutually productive cooperation.
The run-up to this election was filled with fears of democratic backsliding. Faye now faces the challenge of inspiring confidence on all levels. Experts say Senegal will need sweeping reforms if it's to move forward.
There's a need for grand legislative reform that is going to probably devolve the presidential power in the country, and then to also fight corruption, which I think has been the bane of development in this country.
Now it's time to see if Faye, a young and unexpected leader, can really lead Senegal into a new chapter.
Journalist Arwa Bakala is in Dakar following this story for us. Arwa, this is a big day in Senegal, obviously. In just a few hours, the youngest president in the history of Africa, youngest elected president, will be sworn in. What's the atmosphere like in Senegal?
Well, the atmosphere in Senegal is just that people just got back from Easter celebrations. It's very calm. Some have left the city for holiday week. And as on Thursday, it will happen the Independence Day. Some other are still working, for sure. You can also feel the relief on people's face. And the 2 years of turmoils are over now. And some of them are happy to see Macky Sall just leaving the country or leaving power. Yet it's an historical moment to leave. And many will certainly follow the swearing ceremony on radio and TV and will take their break. And the city, the atmosphere in the city here in Dakar, it's also very secured because many presidents will attend the ceremony, such as the Gambian president, Bissau Guinea president, Mauritania, Sierra Leone, and Cabo Verde, also the representative of ECOWAS and African Union.
Now, Bassirou Diomaye Faye winning this election came as a bit of a surprise to many. Do you think that the transition to the new government will be smooth? What challenges will the new leader face?
Well, there is many challenges. The unemployment youth, the fact that They needed to also to redistribute the wealth because the exploitation of the oil and gas is expected to start for this year. So there is lots of expectation. And also there is also economic and social expectation regarding this new president and taking care of the youngs. But they are very aware on the fact that it will take time. Maybe things will not be fixed until maybe 5 years for some topics here. But it's a surprise overall because everybody thought that it was going to be a boring presidential race, and that's the establishment had enough sponsors to submit to the constitutional court. And it's a surprise also because it's a hell of a destiny for a 44-year-old man, and who happened to be detained in prison less than a month ago, and he was unknown from everybody a year ago, and the amnesty law came as a deus ex machina in his storyline. So yeah, so this is the reason why it's been a surprise. And you have also the tentative of postponing the election from Macky Sall that happened. That is also quite a surprise. And also people are used maybe seeing a coup happening in African countries here. But Senegal led these elections as a tremendous example of a good democracy.
An exciting day in Senegal. Journalist Arwa Bakala in Dakar, thank you very much.